Deputy Chief of Staff of the Office of the President, the officials of the Presidency, Member of Parliament for Arutu Senior West, District Chief Executive for Arutu Senior District Assembly, the promoter, management and staff of Apeb Cylinder Manufacturing Company Limited, traditional rulers, residents of Chochoe, fellow Ghanaians, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to be here this morning to join you to commission the Apeb Cylinder Factory, an enterprise operating under government's One District, One Factory initiative. This facility is a further concrete manifestation of the new paradigm of economic development, which this administration has been vigorously pursuing since 2017, of insisting on value-addition industrial activities within a conducive and business-friendly environment, is making headway. I came into office in 2017 with a clear appreciation of the fact that unless we industrialize with the goal of adding value to our primary products, we cannot create the necessary numbers of high-paying jobs that will address the great problem of unemployment, as well as enhance the living standards of the mass of our people. That is why government took steps to roll out the 1B1F initiative. Thus far, 125 factories operating under this initiative have so far employed 160,823 people, whose industry would have been at home tiddling their thumbs with no hope in sight. When all idea of projects, 1B1F projects, come on stream, we expect some 295,725 more Ghanaians to get jobs. Clearly, this policy has the potential to absorb many more young persons into well-paying, sustainable jobs within their district, municipal, or metropolitan assemblies. What we are witnessing here today in Chochoe is a true reflection of the benefits of the ID1D1F policy, i.e. the creation of hundreds of direct and indirect jobs in the expansion of value addition activities in the country. It is gratifying to note that PEB is one of the companies being considered by the National Petroleum Authority for the rollout of the new cylinder recirculation model, which is expected to commence in the last quarter of this year. With the company currently employing some 250 people, who are mainly from this constituency, with the number expected to increase to 500, I want to reiterate government's continued commitment to providing strategic support to companies and enterprises such as APEB operating in Ghana. We will continue to enhance the existing incentive framework designed to make 1B1F designated companies more competitive and sustainable. The incentives, which include tax holidays, import duty waivers, and interest rate subsidies, are designed to help build the capacities and competitiveness of these enterprises and to position them for greater productivity and efficiency. We are waiting patiently for Parliament to give its approval to the fiscal incentive package, and I ask respectfully the Parliament expedites action on the matter, which has been somewhat delayed. It is important for investments, that the legal processes for the grant of the package be completed as soon as possible. I encourage the proprietors and management of Apeb Cylinder Manufacturing Limited to take further advantage of this package and establish some similar industrial enterprises in other parts of the country. I commend the promoter, Mr. Ebenezer Pierre, management and staff of Apeb for establishing this part. that is capable of competing in the global market, especially at the time that trading has commenced under the African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement, one of the great punches to Africa's future prosperity. Before I conclude, Minami, ladies and gentlemen, I want to assure you of government's unalloyed commitment towards the development of this constituency and indeed of every constituency in the country. A few minutes ago, I cut the sword for the official commencement of construction of the Bedrasi-Kasua Road. Already under the Akufo-Addo government, we completed the construction of the Bedrasi-Addo Road and the Bedrasi-Suigi Road. In this constituency, the construction of a district hospital under Agenda 111 is also going ongoing at Ahintia, not too far from here. In honor of the late Helen Aisoko, who comes from here, I've instructed the Minister for Roads and Highways to commence work on the construction of the Akuti Junction to Senya Brokun Road. As you know, one of your very own, the Director of Communications at the Presidency, Mr. Eugene Ahim, has done a very good job in lobbying persistently for this road to be constructed, just as he did for the Bedrasi-Kasua Road. And I assure you that it will be completed before 2024. It is public knowledge that he has intentions of contesting on the ticket of the MPP in 2024. If he is successful in the MPP parliamentary primaries, and I'm confident that he will do an excellent job as Member of Parliament for you, and I appeal to all of you to support him if and when that time comes. You'll see for yourself what he's doing for our little Senya West. Indeed, as it is evident, as all of you can see, that when the MPP is in power, our little Senya West develops. Accordingly, my honourable ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to declare our PEM Cylinder Manufacturing Limited duly commissioned. May God bless our PEM Cylinder Manufacturing Limited and us all. And may God bless our homeland down and make her great and strong. Thank you for your attention.
His Excellency.